Daniel, will you be wearing a mask if you're asked to?
What's happening, Pete? I'll tell you what, I'm not going to wear one, and I'm not going to be locked down anymore either. And I think I speak for the majority out there of British people, where I think we forget sometimes that the government actually worked for us, not the other way around, yeah? We are the music makers. We are the dreamers of dreams. If me and 5 or 6 million other people went down to Parliament today, we could go down there and remove every member of Parliament physically and take them outside.
Well, we don't want to do that. We don't want to be physically removing anybody.
No, but listen, Pete. The point I'm making is it's not literal. The point I'm making is they work for us. Yeah.
Yep.
We don't want to be locked down anymore. We don't want any more restrictions. We're going to have to live with this.
Mm-hmm.
From the very beginning of this situation, the government lockdowns don't work. What they should have done is concentrated on the weak, the vulnerable, and the elderly, people that this is actually going to affect.
So they got it wrong from the start, Daniel, you think?
Well, they should have concentrated on this new flu plus one is going to affect vulnerable people, weak people, people with comorbidities. They're the people that are actually, but not our kids. Don't try and jab my kids and put masks on my kids or people like me, because you've got more than under the age of 50, 400 people drown in Britain every year. Much less than that died of COVID-19. Are we going to shut all the swimming pools down and the coast down?
You mentioned your kids, Daniel. It is undeniable that, I mean, 1 in 11 kids were off school last week because of COVID symptoms. They were taken out of school because they had COVID symptoms.
Yeah.
It's undeniable that children can get COVID. Should we not do things to protect them? What alternative would you have?
No, Pete, listen, my daughter has tested positive for having COVID about 4 days ago.
I'm sorry to hear that.
No, don't be sorry, because there's nothing wrong with her. She's got no symptoms whatsoever. Everyone else has had a test in the house, and we're all negative. I can't explain that. But all I know is the government got it wrong. Lockdowns don't work. All you did was destroy viable business. You've got people dying of other cancer. Look at that girl. People in their 30s and 20s and 40s dying of cancer. How many more lost years have we seen? Over 1 million women not having cervical or breast screening. You know, it's not acceptable. From the very beginning, they should have just said, if you're vulnerable, weak or elderly, you need to follow these guidelines. Everyone else has pretty much got a virtually nil chance of dying. Why have we been locked away? Look at the damage we've done. We put over two trillion pounds worth of debt on our children's futures. You know, that's without all the other health. It's gone too far now, and the people have had enough. And I can tell you now, I'm not going to adhere to any guidelines. I'm not going to do it. And the bulk of the population feel like me. I've had enough now. Right? They work for us. The government work for us, not the other way around. You can't keep telling me what I'm going to do, because eventually you'll get revolt. And when people like me that have got their own businesses and are successful people, when I feel like revolting,
yep,
and when I feel like going, you know, fighting back, you in society, you know you've got a problem, because people like me shouldn't be doing it. Right?
Sure. Okay.
I've had enough now, Pete, and I think it's time that we fought back, told the authorities how we feel, leave us alone, concentrate on the weak, the vulnerable,
okay,
and the elderly that
okay.
are actually affected. Everyone else should be left alone. Leave us alone.
My thought is that my best friend just returned from 2 months in Spain, and it appears that we are being completely conned here in our country. Just the comparison that she's made, for instance, there's no free testing in Spain. So if you feel that you've got COVID symptoms, you pay either £90 for PCR or €40 for the antigen. So obviously, people in Spain are just not bothering to get tested because they are not going to, you know, pay that kind
of
money.
It's a lot of money.
It is a lot of money. So the Spanish are laughing at us, and not only the Spanish, everyone around Europe, because long story, but there's a lot of other countries that, you know, people from other countries that we've been chatting to, and they're fully aware that we are doing far more testing than any of the European countries, which is why our numbers are, you know, ridiculously high. I think that the whole thing has become extremely sinister. The government, whenever you see a government minister being interviewed, particularly by talk radio, and once they get questioned a little bit deeper than any of the other mainstream media question them, they just waffle and they just lose their train of thought. A great example was yesterday when Dr. Simon Clark was on, and every time Mike got the better of him, he couldn't answer the questions. They are just waffling their way through it. one minute they're telling us that we've got to learn to live with COVID. The next minute they're talking about Plan B. And this has been the problem right from the start, that just the government, the way they've handled it, I think we've all lost faith in them. I certainly, like most people on your show this morning, I'm not going into any more restrictions. I'm going to see my family at Christmas and my friends. I'm afraid, like most of the other people, I'm completely done with it until the government can convince me that they're on the right track. But we've all been vaccinated now, and that was what they said would take us out of this. But no, they're prepared to carry on with it. And I don't know how long this is going to go on for.
I just think there's a huge lack of enforcement, Shirley, as well. I mean, I take the tube in London. I live in London and I take the tube fairly often. And, you know, a lot of people aren't wearing masks. I don't wear a mask in the tube. There are lots of people who aren't. But yet we have these announcements all the time all over the public address system saying, you know, it's mandatory to wear a mask on Transport for London. So I just wonder how enforceable it is. No one has ever said to me on the tube, you must wear a mask, or I'm sorry, sir, we can't take you on this train if you aren't wearing a mask. So I just wonder how enforceable it is, because law is, you know, is with consent. It's the consent of the people. So if people like you, Shirley, who sound like a very upstanding, law-abiding citizen, you know, 99.9% of the time, is saying, actually, hold on a second here, I'm not going to obey these laws. I mean, it would be absurd to implement them the whole time, wouldn't it?
Absolutely. And the gentleman that you had on earlier that fought in the Korean War, or whichever war it was.
Yes, it was, you know, the Korean War, yeah.
Full respect to him. But unfortunately, there are so many people like him that the government have managed to terrify. And you see it every day in supermarkets, elderly people walking towards you, but they walk around you because they think you're a walking virus. And people, unfortunately, have been very, very scared. And this is what the whole mask thing is about, to keep us in a state of fear. I'm not sure where we're going to go from here, but it's all wrong.
Well, first of all, I absolutely pretty much agree with every word that the previous caller, Shirley, has said. She's absolutely spot on. I don't think lockdowns, any further restrictions, I just don't think they work, to be totally honest with you. I think this is something that, there is a virus out there. I think we all accept that. I think it's just something we're going to have to live with and work around.
Are you worried when you go outside your door? Are you sort of thinking there are things I can do to stop getting COVID because I don't want to get it? Or do you just think, actually, if I get it, I get it, and I'll move on from that position if it happens?
I just think to myself, you can catch viruses from anywhere, I guess, whether it's COVID, whether it's cold. And at the moment, I have to admit I've got a little bit of a cold at the minute, but I'm susceptible to them anyway for some strange reason. So, no, I don't. I just get on with my life as best as I can. I work, you know, I go at my job, I go in people's houses. Some of the houses are probably not as, shall we say, nice as others, but that's, you know, it is what it is. I just get on with my life as best as I can.
Okay.
I don't wear masks.
Yep.
I think we've just got to learn to live with it. It's there.
Okay.
What they should be doing is, if there are ways of preventing COVID, I mean, if for the sake of argument, vitamins are proven to work, then they should be saying, we advise you very strongly take multivitamin tablets every day, stuff like that.
Well, I'm a bit annoyed with, you know, I like your program a lot. You do give the voice to the silent majority, but I'm disappointed in all the presenters that's been presenting talk radio for the past week. You are encouraging people to undermine the laws, law and order in this street. You cannot choose to say, I will refuse to obey wearing a mask, I will refuse to do this.
But people are, Derek, sorry to interrupt you, I mean, people are doing that. People are saying that they won't wear a mask. And
yeah, but you're encouraging it. All the presenters...
We're having the debate, Derek. I mean, some people have strong opinions, but tell me your opinion. Tell me why you think people should wear masks and should obey any restrictions that come in. Let us know what you think.
Right, I'm Second World War generation, and I'm disappointed, quite frankly, at this modern generation. You choose to undermine the laws. Why we've got streets that's unsafe is particularly because people are saying we won't carry out this law. I'll tell you what, if it becomes law and someone refuses to carry out and they get a criminal conviction, Do they realise they won't be able to travel to America? And I'm afraid, yes, you're quite right. It is a debate, and people are entitled to all their opinions. When I was in the Korean War in the 50s, I went on leave to Tokyo to get out of the trenches. I noticed they were wearing masks in those days, in the early 50s. And it does help prevent infection. Why do you think we didn't have much flu last year? It was because people were wearing masks. And for these people to keep saying masks are no good, there's your proof. There was hardly any flu last year.
Derek, we've got to get on to another caller, but thank you so much for calling us today. And thank you. You served in the Korean War. Thank you for your service to our country as well. Amanda is in East Sussex. Amanda, what do you think of this very thorny issue?
Hi, Peter. Nice to talk to you.
Nice to talk to you too.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry. I've got a completely opposite view to your last caller.
Don't apologise. Tell us what you think.
I do respect, you know, his age and experience and everything. But the reality here is we cannot keep threatening people's jobs and livelihoods and mental health with further lockdowns. It is just not right. It's actually more detrimental to keep threatening and using this as a tool than it is to actually just allow people to take responsibility for themselves, because this is what it should be about. We should be now allowed to have our own freedom to make our own choices, and we are not being given our freedom of choices, and that's what really bothers me the most. Our freedom of choice seems to be being eradicated, and that is wrong. We live in a democracy. We live in a world where we are supposed to be allowed to choose for ourselves whether we take the vaccine or not, whether we choose to stay indoors and lock ourselves down or not, whether we want to lose our jobs or not. That's up to us. It shouldn't be up to the government to wield that kind of power.
Amanda, you're saying, you know, I have a lot of sympathy with a lot of what you're saying, and I think the uncertainty is actually having huge, the uncertainty and the will it, won't it happen. I mean, that's hugely insecure for a lot of people. It's making people lose sleep. It's making people have real problems in terms of how their job is, and worrying about that. But it's interesting you say we live in a democracy. I mean, we vote for the government. The government is democratically elected. Surely if it tells us what we should do, if it's saying, you know, scientifically you should be wearing a mask, the virus is getting worse, 50,000 cases, shouldn't we observe that?
Well, there comes a point in any society, as Lord Sumption has pointed out a number of times now, that if the government is making rules and laws that are immoral, then it is the right of the populace to actually go against those rules. So I'm sorry, but I do not agree with these kind of rules and restrictions on our freedoms. It is immoral, and the government should not have the power to keep doing this.